Hello everyone, this is the remodel. So up today, we've got another brown box video. So you already know what this is, I don't. So let's see, what do we have today? Is it another one from Japan? I don't know. Or perhaps a steam engine from Great Britain. We'll see. Okay, so what is it? Oh, well, this looks like a Bachmann model. Let's get rid of this. And, yeah, looks like it comes from Rails of Sheffield. Okay, so I can see that they've tested it. Thank you for testing it before sending it on the other side of the world. Oh, steam locomotive. An ROD280. I think I've ordered this about 6 months ago. So the product code for this is 35-176 Railway Operating Division ROD280, running number 2406, and it's an LNWR Black. So let's open it up and see what it is. I actually don't quite recall last time I did a tender engine. Must have been quite a long time ago. So, what do we have here? Well, first of all, we can see that this product was made in the spring of 2019. Oh, they've actually even included a checklist of the test that they did. Some people don't like it. I actually do, because I prefer my stuff to work once it gets to me as opposed to not working. Elgin. So let's take a look at the instruction first. It actually is pretty beefy. You see, there's a whole bunch of details that we can install. Mostly. I don't think I'm gonna be able to install them. At least that's a lot of things. Bachmann Collector Club, service request. Okay. Okay, so first of all, I see this warning sign. Usually coming from Bachmann, it's not always a good thing. Because sometime I've seen Bachmann locomotive just being very fiddly in the connection between the tender and the locomotive, and I was actually scared about breaking the wires that link both because of the way it was made. So let's take a look at the detail bag first. Okay, so what do we have in this? So we have a couple of braking system, a place for speakers, some chain link coupling, and a whole bunch of what I assume are drain cocks. On a side note about details bag, at first I was wondering why they didn't install all of the thing that came in it at the factory. Then sort of realized once I've installed a couple of details on other locomotive that if you install all of them, well, your locomotive can't turn on track anymore, so it's, I guess they don't put them on just because they want to give you the option of running your train as opposed to just display them. So let's open this up. And look at it a bit closer. First of all, the weight, this seems to be pretty good. Let's just take a look with the trusty scale. So I had to change the battery and the scale looked like they died on me. So anyway. So this model is actually 360 gram. So I guess we're going full circle with this one. With my original thought, I think this is pretty good for a model of this size. It is full of tiny little parts here. First thing I've seen is that the handrails at the back of the cab here that you can see, they seem to be very, very easy to catch on the brake lever right here. So this is one thing you may want to watch out. Also, generally speaking, I'm holding it in my hand right now and I can tell you this is a very, very not friendly experience. I feel like I have to be extra careful about where I put my fingers and everything because there are so many small parts on this. So let's start from the front. I really like that smoke box handle, very old style. We have a buffer beam. Any sprung buffer? Nope, no sprung buffer. Got a little condensation pump here. Very, very fine handrails, that's good. I like the splasher on this model. I don't know if you see it, you get like that single one there and then a very large one in the back. That's pretty, pretty original. We do have a representation of the mechanical part underneath the boiler, if you can see them. Right where the reversing rod is. Actually, at the end of the reversing rod. So on top here, we got some turn metal safety valves and whistles. Some glazing on the cab. The cab itself looks to be reasonably well painted. I don't know if you can see this here, but even the gauges are painted, and you know, when I see this, it's always a bit of an achievement because it's so small. So about the tender itself, well, we have a plate that can be lowered. Other than that, it's a very, very plain looking tender. There's no notable thing about the livery or anything. The only part that is painted is actually the rear buffer beam, which is painted red. And again, no sprung buffer on the back also. We do have coal. Coal seems to be a piece of metal. Gives a reasonable weight to the tender. Okay, so I'm gonna try to turn this around, but this is so fragile that I'm not gonna try to do it over the air like this. Let me just put it down. Turn it like this, and then we're gonna look if we have any other special detail that we didn't see on the first side. So again, this side, not much livery going on this model. We do have a builder's plate, probably see it in on the other side also, and the running number on a reasonably well printed plate. A very bare looking tender with nothing written on it. I mean, we can't blame Bachmann for this because it's probably prototypical, but still, I mean, it's not one of the most interesting one I've looked at so far. Okay, what about underneath? Our thing over here. Well, first of all, we got the pilot wheel right here that is on its own pilot bogey. Then we have some pickups on all the driving wheels here. Doesn't appear to have any pickup in the tender though, so yeah, there's no pickup on this. Otherwise yeah, we'd hear a little something. Kind of strange because it actually has its own place for the decoder in the tender with all those wires that you are able to see. You got NEM pockets at each end right here and on the front wheel. I really don't like those tender to local connections. I don't know if you can see this here. I'm gonna try to angle it a bit. This is like not holding anything. So it's very, very easy to damage those wires if you're not paying attention. So you know that caution sign that I showed at the beginning that says lift both at the same time? Yeah, they mean it. I also had the same issue with two other locomotives from Bachmann. So I have not run it yet, as I don't have a current layout for double O locomotive. But my initial impression on this, well, the weight is good. There seems to be a lot of intricate details. The livery itself is a bit of a letdown, and that's not because of Bachmann. I think it's because just the model itself. Also, this model for a tender locomotive was actually relatively cheap. I think if it's under 1,000, yeah, of course I paid under 1,000, but I paid under £100 for this, which I'm not exactly sure when I purchased this exactly, but a tender locomotive from a major manufacturer right now that you know, it has modern documentation and modern packaging, so it was built in 2019. Well, BT, you're gonna stay forever with this locomotive. Let me just put this here. So yeah, I was saying that any tender locomotive for about £99 or probably even less, I think I paid in the 80s for this, is good in 2023. And I guess it was also good back in 2019 when this thing was built. Today's model, I mean, they're very, very expensive. I personally do not think that they are worth what they are being sold as. I took a look just briefly on my phone here while I was doing this review here. So good thing that the battery on my scale failed, so I could take a little break from it. And they think that they can sell this to you for about twice the price. I don't think it's worth that. But for under 100, I think that this is very reasonable. And provided it runs good, I think it's a good deal at that price. So if you can find it to the proper price, yeah, sure, give it a shot. Otherwise, near £200, just pass. So on this note, this was Leeway Model. Leeway Model out.